Okay, do you guys have audio now? Hopefully that didn't completely destroy the video. I'm gonna delete these. All right, so hopefully you guys can hear me this time. Sorry about the technical difficulties before. So I've basically just been working on this image that's probably going to be for like a poster or a small print. I'll be sending it out to my patrons and possibly putting it up for sale on some of the online conventions that are coming up later this summer. Which I'll let you know about on the page. So, since you can hear me now, the program I'm using is Krita, which is basically a free version of Photoshop. It offers a lot of the same functionality, and it's just really good for comics and digital art in general. So, if you're into that, I highly recommend giving it a try. Right now, I'm on the inking, quote unquote, inking stage of this drawing. I generally start out with a sketch, either a digital one or one that I've done by hand. And line work is step two. Some days it is more of a struggle than others. For some reason, this plate does not want to get drawn. So, since you can hear me now too, feel free to post your questions in the comments. We're going to have to kind of start over since I don't have access to comments from the first video. Basically, I had to sign out, make sure it was on the right microphone, and then sign back in. So, I had to stop what I was doing before. Hey Joe, I have a bunch of people that I know are stopping by to check out this video, so that's cool. Hope you guys are all doing well. I know quarantining and coronavirus are still kind of weighing heavy on everything, but I hope you're all staying safe and staying sane. I've mostly just been holed up at my house with my boyfriend for the last 3 months or so. But we're doing pretty well. I think I'm sort of uniquely suited to quarantine because I don't go out much. Is this representative of the type of music you chill out to? Yes and no. I kind of listen to a lot of different things. I'm not a total metalhead like this poster would imply, but I do like, occasionally listening to like Mercure or something like that. But most of what I like falls under like the post-punk umbrella, I would say. So not quite this. Testing out my new brushes. I recently downloaded some free brushes for this program, and they're so far working out pretty well for me. So I'll probably link to those in the comments as well when I'm done. Listen to any Broadway music. I'm not like hugely into musicals. The musicals I like tend to be either like Disney musicals or occasionally I'll listen to songs from Les Mis, but I don't have like a lot of Broadway songs on a playlist or anything. I am going to be going to like a remote viewing party of Hamilton next month, though, so I'm excited about that. Hey, Neil. I have to say hi to all my friends who have signed in. Oh, my mom's here too. Hi, Mom. Yeah, right now, if you're just tuning in, I'm sort of on the inking stage of this. I'm just going to try and get the line work down so I can hopefully get started on color before the video is over. I know I'm already like 20 minutes into my time, so I have a lot of time here because I have to go around 2:45. But this should be okay. Oh yeah, I really like The Mandalorian. Think I binged that whole show like the first week it was out or something. Highly recommend it if you've got a Disney Plus account. I was gonna make this a little vignette. I make this like a cover for something. I don't know. I need to come out with a second volume of Roxy Comics. I've only got the one print comic so far. Did you draw this on paper with a marker and scan it, or write on the computer with the tablet? I drew this one with the tablet. Normally, I would do it by hand, but lately I've been kind of been trying to transition to all digital, just to like save cost on materials and sort of save myself the headache of having to scan everything. Because my scanner is not, the best quality, so it would always kind of make things a little bit pixelated looking, and they just wouldn't be as good. So trying to do everything on the computer now, and it's a bit of an adjustment, but I think it's going okay. I feel like I improve a little bit every time I do a new drawing, so that's helpful. Do you have a YouTube or a Twitch? I don't have a Twitch channel. I do have a YouTube, but there's not much on it. I haven't done any live draws on YouTube. I've done a few time-lapse videos, which I've shared with my Patreon subscribers. So once we're done here, I might post a link to that channel and you guys can check them out. Pretty old now, and they're from when I was still very new to video, so they're not the very best quality in the world, but if you're interested, you can check them out. Normally I would go over this in black, but I actually kind of like how the purple makes this all look, so I think I'm gonna change colors here and just select from the sketch. This with a different type of pen. That's quite a bit. Haley, Lee's saying the Cowboy Bebop time lapse is awesome. I do have a time lapse video of a fan art that I did of Spike Spiegel from Cowboy Bebop. If you have not seen Cowboy Bebop, I highly recommend it. It's one of my favorite animes of all time. And I set it to the opening theme song, which is, you know, also one of the greatest TV theme songs of all time, in my opinion. So I'll post a link in just a few minutes. Reminds me of a Gretzko. That's awesome. I take that as a compliment. I think a Gretzko is adorable. So this image is probably going to become like an 11 by 17 printer poster, like I said. And if this ends up going on any sort of storefront in the near future, I'll be sure to post a link for you guys. There's a lot of conventions and stuff are going fully digital this year. So there's like Space Online 2020, which I'll be taking part in here in a few weeks. And I think there's a few more coming up later in the summer and the fall. So I will keep you posted if and when you'd like to purchase any artwork from me or just, you know, watch more videos. This is one of those where I probably gonna end up liking the pencil sketch better than the final product. Oh, t-shirt. This might be a good t-shirt. It'd be a pretty big design for a t-shirt, but I think it might work. I do have a storefront on Threadless, which I haven't updated in a while, but is still functioning, so if you're into some Roxy merch, I will also post a link to that, and hopefully a few of you guys can check it out, order a t-shirt or a sticker or something. I need to start updating that more. I think I'd like to start posting just more Roxy art in general on the Facebook page, not necessarily comics. So one thing that I've been doing that's made like the digital art side of this more comfortable for me is I put a piece of printer paper over top of my tablet, and it just sort of recreates the feeling of a sketchbook and makes it feel much more natural to someone like me who hasn't done a lot of digital painting. I'm used to sketching by hand, so it's just kind of like easier to transition to that than just straight up using the tablet by itself. I should bring this character into a comic at some point. Kind of proud of it. Sort of like fantasy metal Roxy. My brother is in a black metal band, or was for this past few years, and I think he would be proud. Out, make sure everything's looking good, and zoom back in. So I might make this into a two-parter, since I'm already 16 minutes into this video. I'd like to actually get to a finished image with you guys on live draw, but I always end up running out of time. So I'll probably just do line work today and then save it for my next video, which should be possibly this Saturday. I want to set up a regular schedule so I can do live draws like twice a week or so. And you know, because I've been really enjoying them, and it would be cool to eventually reach more people. And possibly like do the Facebook ad share thing, because money. They're just kind of fun. I should really set up the YouTube channel to be a more active part of what I'm doing here. I don't know if you guys would enjoy that. Switch brushes here. This isn't a comic, this is just like a little bit of promotional art, so it's sort of a more freeform style than I'm used to using. Getting to experiment with some different markers and pens and stuff instead of my usual just brush pen. I'm really liking how this is turning out. Except for that teapot, that looks a little janky. That's another thing about how I work. I start over a lot. Like I'll draw something, five times and realize I still don't like it, so I'll just keep going and retrying it until I get it right. Shorter in the drawing, it's a little bit awkwardly tall. So I was using the Wayback Machine recently. I don't know if you guys have ever tried that, but basically it's snapshots of old websites, snapshots of the internet as it was, years ago. And it's still ongoing, but I went to some sites that I like used to really love when I was in high school. So like some of the artists that I would check out and stuff in like 2006, 2007. And it was crazy. Like, I think at the time, I was convinced that anyone who had like an art website was a celebrity of some kind. And to an extent, that was true, but like, most of them were, on par with what I'm doing now. So, like, I probably could have reached out to some of them. When I was 15 or 16, and like asked for advice, or just told them, "Hey, I really like your work," and probably would have been okay. Was kind of crazy too. Like I was looking at these websites, and it's like there wasn't social media or anything back when I was like early in high school. We were like just starting to get MySpace and stuff, and Facebook wasn't quite a thing yet. So, like, there weren't these big hubs where you could, just look up artists all in one place. You had to kind of find somebody's website and then go to their list of links and, click on each individual one until you found artists that you really liked. Which was obviously a lot more work, but some of my favorite artists to this day, I found doing that. So it was kind of fun to go back through and go down memory lane and check those out. Think I'm gonna use like a sort of mercury brush for this one. And like I said earlier, if you guys have any questions or if you'd like to ask anything, just leave them in the comments. Ooh, what would you advise your younger self? There's so many things. Mostly they would revolve around like not being quite so self-conscious. Like not letting self-consciousness like dictate what I could and couldn't do. Because I think a lot of young people kind of make decisions based on, what's going to avoid the most embarrassment. And I was definitely one of them for a while. And I feel like, I had a pretty good, childhood and adolescence, but I could have had more fun if I had kind of gotten over some of my key insecurities earlier than I did. And I'm saying this as someone who still has, few insecurities, but who doesn't? The underdrawing off for now. I feel like I've gotten everything kind of laid out. Actually getting near the end of our time here because I have to get off around 2:45. Just gonna finish up a little bit more of the line work here, and then I'll be signing off. Hopefully the next one goes a little more smoothly. I didn't have audio in this one for like the first 10 minutes or so, so I apologize for that. I'll make sure in the future to like have all my settings figured out before it's time to go live. Need to look at my page real quick. Oh, thank you. I had to do a translate on one of the comments I just got, but someone's saying I could do a live draw to win some money, which I really appreciate that. I don't know if I'm that good, but maybe. Well, it is 2:44, so I'm probably going to sign off for the day. I have to go and drop off a print at a client's house, but this has been really fun, and I hope you guys are all doing well. I will sign back on for another live video probably this Saturday, but I will post for sure on the page, so just stay tuned. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.